Bonjour à tous, j'espère que vous allez bien. C'était un petit peu sportif, c'était un petit peu compliqué. Je ne sais pas pourquoi YouTube avait décidé de compliquer les choses. Pour une fois, ce n'était pas moi. So, I hope everyone is good. So today it's intermediate, it will be in mostly in English, but then of course in French too. So let me take the time to say hello to everybody. Olga Ruiz est avec nous, Stardust, bonjour. Yossi est là, Omar est là aussi, Bickert est là, Cosmina Bellou, bonjour, Ice Cubes, bonjour, bonsoir, Hilary est là, Mouskan est là, Victoria Jacques est là, Yasmine est avec nous aussi, Ada est là, bonjour, Dolma, bonjour, qui est-ce qu'il y a d'autre? Mouskan, peut-être que j'ai dit, Tiffany est là aussi, Emma Chomao. YouTube Browser, Rupa est là aussi, Maria Betania. Well, everybody is here. Hein. J'espère que ça va fonctionner. Let's cross our fingers because it's a bad start, but still, it might mean that everything will be perfect. Okay, we can start now. But of course, let's not forget that I would like to have my 100 likes. So you are invited to like and to share. So it would be extremely nice if you could just click on the like button as usually, and then you can invite your family, you can invite your friends. Please be my ambassadors. It would be really nice. Thank you very much. So this is the first thing. The second thing is, of course, before starting, as I always say, it would be good if you could open on a new tab on your device and put a dictionary there. Because basically, of course, I try to respond, I try to answer to all your questions during the live, but in some cases you ask me some questions of translation, and in fact it would go much faster if you would just open a tab. And it's really good because for you after that you can keep a track of the new words that you've been discovering during these exercises. So let's have a look. We've been so far working together. If you have some suggestions, then please feel free to write them right now in the chat. But then we've been coming up with these dictionaries, word reference, DeepL, Collins dictionary, Larousse, and then Google Translate. So pick one of them, try them. It's always interesting to compare the dictionaries, and you will see that something will be good for you. Okay, so open the dictionary, use it during the live, so to make sure that you understand everything. Of course, because this is intermediate, so in that case, I've been translating also the sentences, so I hope it will help you. The translation, it's always with this little tag, with this little American flag, so, and then it's in English, obviously. So we can start now. Alors, bonjour à toutes les personnes. My God, we've got many persons who are arriving. So remember, the reflex, you arrive, you click on like. Merci. So the question of the day, and the question of the day is, est-ce que vous aimez les jeux de société et pourquoi? Est-ce que vous aimez les jeux de société et pourquoi? Pourquoi? You've got 1 minute to answer to this question, so of course it should be in the chat, and after that I will read and correct. C'est la question du jour. Alors, Victoria Jacques is the first one to answer. Oui, mais je n'en ai pas, ou je n'y ai pas joué depuis un moment. Très bien. Ensuite, Dory nous dit bonjour à tous. J'espère que vous allez bien. Je suis tibétain pour apprendre le français, mais je ne connais pas bien comment on l'apprend. Dorji, you can participate to the lesson. Okay, so this one it's intermediate, so it means that I will mostly use English. Tomorrow it will be advanced, and I'm not using English at all. It's only in French. Alors, Bourneville Lover, oui, je les aime beaucoup. C'est une façon amusante, féminin, pour passer du temps avec la famille. Et j'aime gagner. YouTube Browser, j'aime le Scrabble parce que c'est amusant. Tiffany, c'est amusant de jouer avec les amis et la famille. Eh oui. Nivin, oui, je les aime. Très bien. Fiona Adams, bonjour, you can participate. Fernanda Garcia, j'adore les cartes. Laurel, oui, j'aime parce qu'il m'aide à penser. Remember to conjugate your verb, aider. Hein, you need to conjugate it. Ice Cubes, oui, j'aime les jeux de société parce qu'ils sont très amusants. Très bien. Yasmine, oui, j'aime les jeux de société. Car c'est une bonne activité pour le reconfinement. Oui, c'est ça. Hein. C'est des nouveaux mots. Reconfinement. So, we're getting some new words now. It didn't exist before, but now it does exist. Masculin. Mouskan, j'aime beaucoup les jeux de société parce qu'ils sont assez amusants et intéressants aussi. Don't forget the S at the end of intéressant, Mouskan. Léoul Kiros, je n'aime pas les jeux de société parce que je ne sais pas. D'accord. Hilary, j'aime les jeux de société parce qu'on peut. Remember, peu. Should be written P-E-U-T, hein, because it's the third person of the singular, s'amuser et être ensemble. Et Macho Maro, je n'aime pas les jeux de société parce que je ne gagne jamais. Ok, Desarlika, bonjour, bonjour Desarlika, you can participate. Omar, j'aime un peu, mais je préfère faire des choses différentes. Mouskan qui nous dit j'aime Ludo et Carom, d'accord. Tenzin, oui, j'aime jouer aux jeux de société. Cosmina Bellou, oui, parce que c'est drôle. Sidant nous dit non, je n'aime pas les jeux de société parce que je ne connais pas sur les. Ah, je ne connais pas beaucoup de choses sur les jeux, d'accord. Baraka, do you sell courses? Ah, it's a strange question, Baraka. Yes, I do. Renato Silva, quels sont les jeux de société? Well, it's board games in English. Olu Watomi, oui, parce qu'ils me permettent de penser. Yossi, oui, j'aime jouer au solitaire avec les cartes. Oui, oui, oui. Rupa, non, je n'aime pas les jeux de société car c'est très ennuyeux. Ada, je n'aime pas beaucoup la société, malheureusement. Non, Ada, c'est les jeux de société, board games. Ashwati, oui, j'aime jouer beaucoup au carom et au ludo avec mes cousins et mes amis. Maria Bethania, j'aime quelques jeux de société parce qu'ils nous amusent et réunissent toute la famille. Olga, je ne peux rien avec la société. No, but it's board game. It's another thing. Hein. C'est pas une société. Dolma, oui, j'aime bien, mais je ne gagne jamais. Bickert, j'aime le jeu Hockey et Kings qui se joue avec des cartes. Quand j'étais à l'université, j'avais joué et maintenant, parfois, je joue avec mon mari pour gagner un cadeau. D'accord, et Fiona Adams, oui, ça nous garde à l'intérieur de la maison. Bah oui, c'est vrai que c'est peut-être, effectivement, la seule technique pour passer du temps. It might be the only way to spend time inside without becoming crazy. Allez, on continue. Alors, j'ai une question à poser. Est-ce que Victoria Posse est avec nous. Victoria Posse, êtes-vous là, s'il vous plaît? Est-ce que vous êtes là? Je crois que j'ai vu votre nom. So I think that I saw Victoria Posse somewhere. Are you here, Victoria? Est-ce que vous êtes là? Si vous pouvez m'écrire dans le chat, oui, je suis là. Je serai un homme très heureux, s'il vous plaît. Vous allez comprendre pourquoi. Alors, Victoria Posse, nous vous attendons. Est-ce que vous êtes là, Victoria, ou vous n'êtes pas là? Et dans ce cas-là, nous allons continuer notre cours. Victoria, êtes-vous là? Ah, c'est la première fois que j'attends quelqu'un comme ça dans un chat. Alors, je crois que Victoria n'est pas là. Est-ce que nous l'attendons? Nous ne l'attendons pas. Bon, eh bien écoutez, dans ce cas-là, Victoria, si nous avons l'occasion de nous voir demain, j'aurai une petite surprise pour vous, mais je ne sais pas si elle est là. Tenez, on va quand même lui souhaiter quelque chose. J'avais envie, so I wanted since yesterday to actually say thank you to people who have been following the lives and the exercise for a long time. Oui, Victoria, vous êtes là. Eh bien, Victoria... Voilà, je voulais dire à Victoria, regardez, merci. Merci Victoria Posse, parce que Victoria Posse, comme Ice Cubes et comme d'autres personnes, vous êtes là depuis le début. So you are here since the beginning, unfortunately since the first lockdown, fortunately and unfortunately. So I wanted to say thank you to you, because you didn't win anything like Ice Cubes, like other persons. So I thought yesterday that I should thank people who clearly were there since the beginning. So merci beaucoup Victoria Posse. Victoria Posse, vous allez vous enregistrer sur frenchforme.net. Vous allez m'envoyer un message the winner at fluent2plus.com et vous me dites c'est moi et je vais vous donner l'accès à toute la plateforme pour vous remercier. Merci beaucoup, Victoria, de m'avoir fait confiance et d'être là depuis le début. Allez, c'est l'image du jour, it's the picture of the day, and look, oops, I'm going too fast, look at the picture and try to write me one sentence, s'il vous plaît, merci. Alors, Mouskan Batia is the first one to write. Je peux voir un homme avec un masque. Victoria qui dit merci, merci, pas de problème, c'est moi qui vous dis merci. Rupa, qu'est-ce que c'est? Ben, c'est ça la question. Yesero, on dirait un homme qui porte un masque devant un panneau électrique. Yasmine, désolé, je vois le couvre-feu. C'est vrai, c'est vrai. Hein. Nivin, il porte un masque et semble chercher quelque chose. Hilary, je vois un homme qui porte un masque dans la boîte. Renato Silva, qu'est-ce que c'est? UGC. UGC, in fact, it's like pâté. So basically, when you go to this multiplex or then this movie theater, UGC is one of them. So you can see them quite easily if you go to Paris, for instance, or other big cities. So it means that this UGC complex, which is clearly connected to cinema, is closed. Dolma, un homme qui portait un masque en train de regarder des barbelés. Tenzin, UGC est une entreprise, il y a beaucoup de boot, c'est très chaud. je n'ai pas compris de boot, qu'est-ce que c'est? Oluwatomi, cette photo est brouillée. Yossi, un homme porte un masque, il regarde les néons. Ice Cubes, il y a un homme devant les lettres en néon. Victoria Jacques, quelqu'un qui se promène la nuit pendant le confinement. Maria Bethania, est-ce que c'est vous sur la photo? Non, c'est pas moi. Mais peut-être que ça pourrait être moi, devant les grilles en disant « Ouvrez, ouvrez le cinéma !» Ashwati, dans cette photo, il y a un homme qui porte un masque sur son visage, passant devant un panneau électrique UGC. Desarlika, il y a un homme qui est attiré par une publicité. Bickert, je vois un homme qui porte un masque, un homme regarde la cage. Ada nous dit « Pas de cinéma pour lui !» Oui, c'est ça en fait. Mais pas de cinéma, hein. C'est pour tout le monde maintenant. Renato, l'homme confiné à UGC. Ah non, ce serait idéal ça. Lolkiros, il porte un masque et regarde la lettre ou les lettres. Stardust, je vois un homme qui aimerait voir un bon film, eh oui, mais qui ne peut pas. YouTube Browser, je vois un homme masqué. On peut utiliser en adjectif avec E accent aigu. So you should put the accent at the end of your E and then it will become an adjective, masqué. Fiona Adams, hop, Fiona has been removing her sentence. Allez, on continue. Alors, la nouvelle du jour, the news of the day. Confinement à Paris, Amazon, c'est la mort de nos librairies, estime Anne Hidalgo, maire de Paris. So remember that Anne Hidalgo is the mayor of Paris, and she's saying, confinement à Paris, Amazon, c'est la mort de nos librairies. One sentence to comment this news. Please, 1 minute and 1 sentence. On y va. Alors, je regarde Omar nous écrit en premier, à mon avis, Omar is putting a teaser. À mon avis, and then we need to imagine the rest. Tiffany qui dit, je préfère les vrais livres. YouTube Browser qui nous dit, Amazon, c'est la mort de toutes, féminin, pluriel, T-O-U-T-E-S, les librairies du monde. Yasmine, mon cœur est triste pour toutes les petites entreprises. Renato Silva, acheter sur Internet tue les magasins physiques. Eh oui. Olu Watomi, à mon avis, je ne pense pas que ce soit vrai. Stardust, à mon avis, c'est correct, c'est vrai. Je préfère être dans une vraie librairie. So be careful because in French, library is a bookstore in English. Hein? It's not a library, it's a bookstore. So you go and you buy books in a librairie in French. Hein? Ensuite, Yesero, il faut qu'elles doivent adapter car les gens ont déjà adapté au monde digital. Desarlika, ce n'est pas une bonne nouvelle. Nivin nous dit, elle a raison. Hein, we tend to go for avoir raison, elle a raison. Bickert nous dit, si oui, les gens préfèrent acheter sur Internet. Yossi nous dit, c'est vrai, parce qu'au temps du coronavirus, les ventes via Amazon ont augmenté beaucoup. Cosmina Bellou, c'est vrai en partie, l'avenir est en ligne, peu importe si la pandémie continue ou pas. Dolma nous dit, c'est-à-dire qu'Amazon est plus sécurisé, une manière plus sécurisée pour acheter des livres pendant le confinement. Hillary qui nous dit, peut-être, mais je préfère les librairies. Moi aussi, j'aime ça, les librairies. C'est une autre atmosphère. Hein. Bonville Lover, oui, c'est vrai. Il n'aide pas ceux qu'il se battait avant. Je ne suis pas sûr d'avoir bien compris votre phrase. Alors, Victoria Jacques nous dit, c'est vrai, Amazon est utile, mais les petites entreprises en souffrent. Mouskan nous dit, les affaires sont difficiles pour les petites entreprises après l'introduction d'Amazon. C'est la même chose en Inde aussi. Omar, à mon avis, maintenant, toutes les entreprises doivent faire des choses nouvelles pour batailler. Ada, les librairies sont mortes depuis des années, pas seulement à cause d'Amazon, mais aussi parce que les gens ne lisent pas de nos jours. Fiona Adams, mais ça aide pendant l'accouchement. La lecture. C'est intéressant, Fiona Adams, comme phrase. It's really interesting what you've been writing. Alors, you probably know it, or maybe not if you're new. So we've been starting to learn French with real persons too, because of course it's good when you listen to me, but it's always good to listen to other persons. And so we've been seeing Juliette Binoche, Audrey Tautou, Charlotte Gainsbourg, et aujourd'hui, and today we will work with Coco Chanel. So it's quite interesting because the interview that I took from Coco Chanel is from 58. So basically, it will be interesting to see if the language has changed slightly or not, if she pronounced differently or if she structured the language in a different manner. On purpose, I've been taking or slicing some short sentences because I thought that at this level, intermediate, it would be easier and nicer to work like that. Okay, so I'm not sure if it was 6 or 7 or 5. We'll see. We have few sentences. The concept is still the same. I will give you the sentences. We listen several times, so in a loop, and then you try to find the missing words. So you will see, and then I think it will be extremely useful. On y va. Ali, this is the first thing. And the first thing, so you can look at, the sentence. And of course, I will have to click. I will make it loop maybe 4 or 5 times. You'll see, you get only 2 words. So I don't think it should be too difficult, but let's see.
Ça m'apparaît stupide à moi, personnellement. 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 Ça m'apparaît stupide à moi, personnellement.
Alors, I can see that you've been already, you've been starting to put your things. So let's have a look at, in fact, what she was saying. So it's interesting to see if it's difficult or not. We'll have to see that. So it was like that. So the first thing was the verb. The verb is apparaître. Chris Phillips is joining us. Bonjour, bonjour, Chris Phillips. You can participate with us. So, apparaître, and then it should be conjugated in the third person. So, basically, A-I-T. We've been discussing about this circumflex on the top of E. If you don't put it, well, it's not the end of the world. The second thing, it was moi, hein, M-O-I, remember? So, ça m'apparaît stupide à moi personnellement. Okay, so let's listen to it one more time and take the time to read at the same time to see if you understand and if you catch the pace of Coco Chanel.
Ça m'apparaît stupide à moi personnellement. Ça m'apparaît stupide à moi personnellement. Ça m'apparaît stupide à moi personnellement.
Allez, let's have a look at the second thing. So second thing is like that. It's short, but then I've been removing, of course, 1, 2, 3, 4 words. So I hope you're ready because we will start right now. Same thing here. I would make it loop for, few times.
Je n'aime pas l'extravagance. Je n'aime pas l'extravagance. Je n'aime pas l'extravagance. Je n'aime pas l'extravagance. Je n'aime pas l'extravagance.
Alors, je remarque que, vous aviez trouvé sans problème. So I can see that you've been finding the proper. So it was, of course, je n'aime pas, and then l'extravagance. Je n'aime pas l'extravagance. So far, so good. I mean, you've been catching everything. Let's listen one more time, and you can listen and read or catch the pace at the same time.
Je n'aime pas l'extravagance. Je n'aime pas l'extravagance. Je n'aime pas l'extravagance.
So the interesting thing in that case, remember, because we've been noticing that, in fact, for the others that we have been so far, they were dropping the first part of the negative form. And you will see that at that time, because we're talking about 58, it was still quite classic to keep the first part of the negative form. Of course, she can remove it, and I think that at one point she will remove it in the interview, but it means that it was more formal in a way. So the first part of the negative form was still there at that time, and then nowadays it tends to be the opposite, so we tend to drop it in most of the cases. Okay, so let's have a look now at, the next one, and it's numéro 3. Numéro 3, so take the time to look at the sentence, and then we'll start to listen and try to find the 3 missing words.
Permettre aux femmes de bouger aisément. 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 Permettre aux femmes de bouger aisément.
Alors, I have the feeling because now it's starting, but really, really quietly. So I think that it might be a bit more difficult in that case. Well, the first thing, it was the verb. The verb, it's permettre. So you can see that it's in the infinitive form in that case. Then you can see that femme is, in fact, in the plural form. And you can see that from the O, remember, A-U-X. And the other one, the last one, it's an adverb. And it's quite interesting because this adverb, now it's not really used that much anymore. Instead of aisément, we would go for facilement now. So aisément used to be quite popular because it's coming from the adjective aisé. But then nowadays we tend to use facilement. But still it's possible, this is a good example, that you can hear it, you can encounter this adverb. Permettre aux femmes de bouger aisément. D'accord? So, same thing here. We'll listen it for it maybe 2-3 times and then just try to get used to the pace of Coco Chanel.
Permettre aux femmes de bouger aisément. Permettre aux femmes de bouger aisément. Permettre aux femmes de bouger aisément.
Voilà. Allez, numéro 4. Numéro 4, same thing here. Take the time to look at the sentence and then, I will start it right now.
La mode, c'est pas ça, vous comprenez. La mode, c'est en avant, c'est pas en arrière, on ne recule pas. La mode, c'est pas ça, vous comprenez. La mode, c'est en avant, c'est pas en arrière, on ne recule pas. La mode, c'est pas ça, vous comprenez. La mode, c'est en avant, c'est pas en arrière, on ne recule pas. La mode, c'est pas ça, vous comprenez. La mode, c'est en avant, c'est pas en arrière, on ne recule pas.
Alors, I can see that it's getting tricky. I am really sorry. I am sorry if it's too difficult for you. But you know, it's always good to have some challenges. It's always good to feel that it's a bit difficult. I think it's good because, once again, it's the real way of talking. People are talking like that, even if it's a bit old, but that was the whole point too. I mean, to see exactly how it was structured and if it's extremely different. So let's see now if you've been writing some things. So from what I see now, I can see that some of you have been, seeing the thing. So let me help you now. Voilà. So we were looking for three things. And the things that we were looking for, in fact, the first one, it was the verb comprendre. And comprendre, it's in that case in the second person of the plural. Vous comprenez. You understand. You can see that, she will use it a bit later, I guess. She is using that to emphasize. So it's like a punctuation. It's like to emphasize. It's like, la mode, c'est pas ça. Vous comprenez. D'accord? La mode, c'est pas ça. Vous comprenez. La mode, c'est en avant. Remember, en avant, it's A-V-A. N-T, and in fact, it's the opposite of arrière that you can see right after. La mode, c'est en avant, c'est pas en arrière. Here it's interesting because c'est pas, you can clearly see that she's dropping the N. She doesn't say ce n'est pas, but in that case, she goes for c'est pas, which is extremely common. C'est pas. And the last thing, it's a verb. The verb is reculer. It's a regular verb from the first group. On ne recule pas. D'accord? La mode, c'est pas ça. Vous comprenez? La mode, c'est en avant. C'est pas en arrière. On ne recule pas. So let's take the time to listen to that one more time. Because I know that it's difficult, but it's a good exercise.
La mode, c'est pas ça, vous comprenez. La mode, c'est en avant, c'est pas en arrière, on ne recule pas. La mode, c'est pas ça, vous comprenez. La mode, c'est en avant, c'est pas en arrière, on ne recule pas. La mode, c'est pas ça, vous comprenez. La mode, c'est en avant, c'est pas en arrière, on ne recule pas.
Alors, Ice Cube is saying, but she swallows every letter. Well, no, because if she was swallowing all the letters, it will be just silent. Allez, let's continue with numéro 5. Numéro 5, you can see that it's a short sentence too. I hope you will be ready because it's starting now.
Et le corps humain bouge tout le temps. 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 Et le corps humain bouge tout le temps.
Alors, I can see that now we are talking, because now people caught it more easily, apparently. So we were looking for three things, and in that case, the first one, it's a substantive, it's a noun, and it's corps. Remember, the way to write corps, it's C-O-R-P-S. We don't pronounce P, and we don't pronounce S. C-O-R-P-S, le corps. After that, it's a verb, and it's a verb from the first group, and it's the verb régulier, bouger. Bouger, in that case, you need to conjugate it in the third person of the singular, because it's le corps humain, so il. And so bouge, B-O-U-G-E. And the last thing, it was temps, hein, because the expression is tout le temps, T-E-M-P-S. Et le corps humain bouge tout le temps. Alors, Christopher, Johnny saying, I did not hear well. Well, I mean, it's an interview, so I don't know if the quality on your side, normally it should be quite good. Well, she's going fast, but it's just the way it is. I mean, people are talking like that normally when they talk. YouTube browser is saying, parce qu'elle a un accent particulier. Not really, she doesn't really have a special accent. She tends to make, if you listen to it, the air, they're extremely rough, and they're like that, which is not really the case nowadays. And she's not really coming from a region or an area where they have a strong accent. So I would tend to say that she's not really having an accent if you are talking about that. From the French Academy point of view, she's talking regular French from France. But from the, well, from the 80s in that, the 50s in that case. So let's go for the, I'm not sure if it's the last one, but then let's have a look at this one. So look at the sentence. Same thing here. We will look for three words. So get ready.
Et ça, comment dire, je crois que c'est le don que je possède. Et ça, comment dire, je crois que c'est le don que je possède. Et ça, comment dire, je crois que c'est le don que je possède. Et ça, comment dire, je crois que c'est le don que je possède. Et ça, comment dire, je crois que c'est le don que je possède.
Alors, in that case, let's have a look, because you're starting to write your thing. So, the first thing, it was vous. We remember that vous, in fact, you write it V-O-U-S. So, it's the subject in that case, because you have comprenez after. Then, the verb is croire. D'accord? Remember that croire belongs to the third group, but then when you want to conjugate it, it's in that case the first person. So je crois, C-R-O-I-S. Je crois, final S not pronounced. And the last thing, it was a verb. The verb is posséder, and posséder belongs to the first group. So when you conjugate it, it's not really tricky. The only thing that is a bit tricky is the accent. As you can see here, well, normally it's posséder with accent aigu, and then it transforms itself into accent grave, possède. Remember, it goes for je, tu, il, and the plural il, tu. So, je possède. Donc, et ça, vous comprenez, je crois que c'est un don que je possède. In that case, I'm going back to exactly the question that was asked by I think it was YouTube browser. If you listen to the way she pronounced the R, I mean they're really strong and they're really like guttural in the throat. So try to get it, because nowadays it tends to be not as strong as that. Okay, so let's listen to that one more time.
Et ça, comment dire, je crois que c'est le don que je possède. Et ça, comment dire, je crois que c'est le don que je possède. Et ça, comment dire, je crois que c'est le don que je possède.
Et voilà, c'est fini. Remember that it's possible to do some things just, I mean, for you in a way. But if you want to, well, work on a French or French-speaking celebrity that you have in mind, send me the suggestion to askvincent@fluent2plus.com, and then I will try my best to find an interview, to find some sentences, and we can work on that. So it's just up to you if you want to suggest a celebrity, or it could be a politician if you want, no problem. I will be pleased to do it just for you. Alors, let's start with the first gift. So we'll have the first gift. The value is $59. And then the idea is, of course, not to start right now. If you know exactly how it goes, then, well, we'll try to start when the music starts. Remember, I will have to press on it, and after that you can give me your suggestions. So let's agree on that. Only persons who did not win anything so far can participate to this little game. Let me explain the game to the persons who are new. If there are persons who are new, I will write on this little paper here a number from 1 to 20. And your task is to try to find this number. So it will go, I hope, quite fast, because we've got a lot of work to do after. So you only give me one number per person. D'accord? Only one, let's be fair, because otherwise it will be extremely stressful and painful to try to track the persons who are doing that several times, and the others will look if you respect the rules. And then, of course, the first person who find the number will have the access to my platform, frenchforus.net. Frenchforus.net, it's only with audio files, okay? So if you like podcast, if you like to listen to things, then this is the place where you can go. So we can wait 1 second, because I will put now on my paper. Voilà. So I've been putting my number. And then in that case, I guess we can start. So now you can start and give me one number from 1 to 20. And the first one to find it will win the access. So let's agree on that, and remember that the rule is quite strict, and in fact it was extremely simple, because I only took the proposition or the numbers that arrived after Ice Cubes, because Ice Cubes so nicely was mentioning the fact that all the things that were above, so meaning by that when the music was not starting, they could not be taken. So unfortunately, because there was one person, I saw the number, but this person didn't wait for the music. So this is Barty. Barty, est-ce que vous êtes là? Because Barty has been offering 19, c'était 19. Félicitations, Barty. So because we're nice, we want to congratulate Barty because, well, bravely, Barty gave us the correct number, 19. Bravo, Barty. We'll be right back. Alors, Barty, probably you know how it works, but then let me remind you the way it will work. You just register to frenchforus.net and you send me an email to the winner at fluent2plus.com, and I will, of course, give you the access to the platform. Félicitations, Barty. Je suis très, très, très content pour vous. And for the others, well, wait a bit, because at the end of the stream or the live, we'll have, well, another one. Allez, remember to like, to share. Click, click, click. It's not really complicated and it changes the whole thing for me. It's just my little pleasure. Merci beaucoup. Alors, nous y allons. So if you remember, I've been inviting you to send me your audio files, and this is exactly what you've been doing, which is extremely nice, so thank you very much. So the idea is to try to see together what is your pronunciation like and how I could help you. So the first person, and we know this person, this is Daria. Daria was so brave because Daria, she's been sending her file. And so we'll listen to Daria and we'll see if there is something to change, modify or comment.
Nous ne pensons pas qu'il faille lui dire maintenant. Nous ne pensons pas qu'il faille lui dire maintenant.
Alors, Daria, c'est très, très bien. It is really, really good, in fact. The only thing, if we really want, because I guess that you want to have some feedback and you want me to try to help you. So I would tell you that probably we should work, or you should work, on your nasal. Okay? So remember, Daria, the way it will go, the nasal, one more time, so I'm putting the camera. The nasal is going in your nose, okay? So this N, because it's not really pronounced, you don't really pronounce it, but still I can feel it, which is really strange. So it means that it should go more strongly in your nose. Pensons. You see, it's round here, like the trompette, if you want, and then it goes in the nose. Nous ne pensons pas. And then there is no N, d'accord? Nous ne pensons pas. And the last one, it was main. Remember, it's a tricky one. A-I-N, or then E-I-N, you pronounce it like un. Main, 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 main. Maintenant, but then the E is dropped, so maintenant. Nous ne pensons pas qu'il faille le lui dire maintenant. Mais c'était vraiment, vraiment bien. It was really good. This is the only thing I could comment if you want to have a feedback regarding your pronunciation. Merci beaucoup. En tout cas, c'était très, très gentil. Regardons ensuite le numéro 2. Alors, numéro 2, nous y allons, et c'est Emma Cho, alors qui nous envoie son fichier, et c'était une autre phrase. Écoutons Emma Cho.
Le bonheur, c'est lorsque vos actes sont en accord avec vos paroles. Le bonheur, c'est lorsque vos actes sont en accord avec vos paroles.
Alors, merci beaucoup, Emma. C'est très, très bien. C'est très, très bien. Alors, if, once again, because I think that the idea is to try to see the little things. So, if we want to take the little things, I will put it like that. In fact, you should go a bit stronger with the R. Look, it will be here, here, and here. So, the tricky thing with the R, and this is usually, well, it depends what your mother tongue is, because it does change and it does impact. So in some cases, R doesn't really exist in mother tongue. So it's like, it's really an effort. So it was quite good because in fact, you've been trying to make it close to, like if it was H in certain languages, like, ah. So you understand that it needs to go out. ha ha ha. Try, and this is the tricky thing, try to make it in like dancing with your throat at the same time. So don't go too strong because it can hurt, but try to work on that. Bonheur. So it goes out, it's not as strong as the H. So bonheur. Okay? Then the other one, it's lor. Lorsk. Lorsk. You can see it's lorsk. And then after that, it's accord. You finish on the r. Accord. And the last one, it's parole. Alright? So le bonheur, lorsk, accord, parole. So it should be possible. You just need to work on that because it's always a process for, I mean, certain nationalities. The R, it's really, really something that is a bit challenging. But you can make it, I mean, no problem. And so far, I mean, the version that you made was really, really good. Everyone understands. Huh? So no stress about that. Let's see the number three. So the third person... It's I just called. I don't know if I just called it is here with us, but then I just called has been sending this sentence. Let's go for it. One second.
Bonjour. Je voudrais pouvoir parler français couramment. Je voudrais pouvoir parler français couramment.
Alors, in fact, I don't really have a lot of things to say. I would go for a rounder ou. I mean, if we really want, alors attendez une seconde, if we really want to try to find something, the who should be maybe a bit rounder. Je vous. So you really need to make it round. So it's normally it's not the problem. Well, it depends. It can be a problem for Spanish-speaking persons or it can be a problem for English-speaking persons. The difference between the U, that is extremely narrow, if you think about your lips, I mean, you squeeze them like that. U. And the U is, in fact, extremely round. U, U, U. So in that situation, really, when you have O and U together, it's really round. Vous, vous, vous. Je voudrais pouvoir. But, I mean, it was really, really good. It's just because I need to find something to say. Because I am like that. But, no, it was really good. Thank you very much. I just called. Let's look at number four. Alors, number four, it was Luciana. Luciana is sending, so it's another sentence. Let's listen to Luciana.
Salut! Nous ne pensons pas qu'il faille le lui dire maintenant. Nous ne pensons pas qu'il faille le lui dire maintenant.
Alors, merci beaucoup, Luciana. It's really good. It is really good. So, one, I mean, the same thing. If we agree that I need to say something, I would go for two things. The first one would be this one. The especially when we're going for the short words like that, you've got only one syllable. And the way it goes, in fact, is the is pronounced quite strongly. So remember that is really as a letter pronounced like So it's going like down in effect. It's not really like going high. It's So when it goes with another, I mean, letter, like in that case, it's N. So one syllable, N. Then te. Je, or it can be the preposition de. So remember that it will be like really, really strong. It's not going high, not even like e. It's not like something between the two. It's really Nous ne pensons pas. And so the second thing I wanted to emphasize, but it was, I mean, it's good like that, but it's the same thing as we had previously. I could hear a little N. And nasal, remember, in the nose and no N at all. Pan, 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 pensons. Nous ne pensons pas. D'accord? So this nasal, it's really a test that you need to do with the nose. You need to close it. You need to see exactly how it sounds because the concept, as I showed previously, for the nasal, on goes there. So if I close it, you can see that, well, it sounds a bit strange, huh? And it's not beautiful at all. So it must go there. So nous ne pensons pas qu'il faille le lui dire maintenant. But it was really, really good, hein, Luciana. Merci beaucoup. And the last person is Rory. I don't know if Rory is here today, but then Rory was nice enough to send his audio file. So let's go for it.
Le bonheur, c'est lorsque vos actes sont en accord avec vos paroles. Le bonheur, c'est lorsque vos actes sont en accord avec vos paroles.
Alors, merci beaucoup, Rory. So he took the time to read it slowly, which is extremely, extremely good. So, Rory, same thing here for you. I would tend to say, but it was not all the time. But I would tend to say, Rory, that you should work a bit on the air. It was quite good, in fact, but if you really want to work a bit more, I mean, this is the thing that you should work on. Okay, so let's agree on that. In that case, you will pronounce bonheur. So go first. I mean, the for the pronunciation, you go strong in the beginning and you tend to reduce. Like for the sounds, you make them last longer and after that you reduce. Le bonheur, this is the way it should go. And after that, you shorten it. Le bonheur. Lorsque. D'accord? Le bonheur, c'est lorsque. Et puis, the last one, I think, but I'm not really sure anymore. I think that the nasal too was, I could hear a little N somewhere. So it should once again go everything in the nose. En, en, en. And there is no N at all. Remember, you press en, en. You can see it doesn't go out. So basically, it means that the thing, everything is going there. Le bonheur, c'est lorsque vos actes sont en accord avec vos paroles. So once again, you were extremely brave. Thank you very much, because this is really nice. I think it's a great exercise, in fact. If you want to, record your sentence, send it to me, and then I will, correct it like that. It's simple. Just record your sentence, send it to pronounce at fluent2plus.com, and then I will include them in the live like I did right now. And the sentence of the week is the one that Rory got. Le bonheur, c'est lorsque vos actes sont en accord avec vos parole. And thank you one more time. It was really brave and really nice. Alors, we do know that there is a specialist regarding the wine in this group, and I'm not mentioning the name of the person, but we will discover one wine today, d'accord? One wine today, and the wine of the day, oh! It's something that should ring a bell for somebody. It's Sixième Sens, and it's a wine that I didn't know. I'm not really a specialist in wine, so this is the reason why. It's rouge, and it's coming from Languedoc. So let's enjoy that. We will, as usual, discover, this beautiful wine, apparently, the three sentences, and then, of course, there are some missing words. So I will read you the first thing. Vous retrouverez des arômes de fruits rouges comme la fraise, la cerise, la framboise, mais aussi une note de vanille. Vous retrouverez des arômes de fruits rouges comme la fraise, la cerise, la framboise, mais aussi une note de vanille. So try to write the missing words. Merci. So let's agree on that. It's really not reasonable because now I can see that there are 154, 53 persons right now. But then I've got only 89 likes. Come on, be nice, be nice, be nice. Like the video. As I said, I want, and it pleases me, it's my little personal pleasure to have 100 likes per exercises or live. So be nice and click on the like. You will make me a happy man. Merci. Alors, in that situation, we were looking for three words. So the first one is a verb, and it's the verb retrouver. As you can see, it's in the futur simple form. So you can see that you need to conjugate that, well, in the vous form. So it means that you will keep the infinitive retrouver. And then you will add the ending for vous. The ending for vous is a Z. Vous retrouverez, and this is the perfect form of the futur simple. The second thing, it's a substantive, it's a noun, and it's fraise. Fraise, remember to write it properly, F-R-A-I-S-E. And the last thing, it's another substantive, it's a noun, and it's framboise, remember to write it, F-R-A-M. So it's not N, it's M, but when you combine the two, it's in fact the same sound, the nasal. Fran, and then B-O-I-S-E, framboise. So after that, we'll have to ask our specialist if it's true or not. I don't know. Let's look at the second thing concerning this interesting wine, le sixième sens. Ce vin rouge a une robe rouge rubis. Ses tanins sont fins et fondus, ce qui en fait un vrai vin de plaisir. Ce vin rouge a une robe rouge rubis. Ses tanins sont fins et fondus, ce qui en fait un vrai vin de plaisir. So please write the missing words. Alors, once again, we're looking for three things. The first thing, it's a substantive. It's robe. And in fact, you write it R-O-B-E. And as you can see, it's quite funny because when we're talking about the wines and when we want to talk about the color of the wine, we are using this word robe. Une robe is a dress normally, but when it's with the wine, we're talking about the color. After that, it was fondu. Well, in that situation, tanin, as you can see, well, with fin, fin gives you, because it's an adjective, you can see that fin is in the plural form, but not in the feminine. So now we know that tanin is, in fact, a masculine plural noun in that case. So fondu should be in the masculine, but in the plural too. So that's the reason why we have the S in the end. F-O-N-D-U-S. Fondu. And the last one, and the last thing, it's a substantive and it's plaisir. So remember that it's masculine. Le plaisir. P-L-A-I-S-I-R. Le plaisir. Un vin de plaisir. Alors, let's have a look at the last thing. And the last thing is coming right now. Une seconde. Voilà. Vous pourrez déguster le sixième sens avec des grillades, de la volaille ou du fromage. Vous pourrez déguster le sixième sens avec des grillades, de la volaille ou du fromage. Alors, I can see that you're starting to give your answers or your words. Ah, apparently, Yesero, he was lost for the two other words. Alors, don't worry about that, Yesero. So look at your screen. So now you can see that the first thing, which is extremely important, and congratulations, Yesero, for that, because you got it. So it's the verb pouvoir. So pouvoir, in that case, it's in the future, futur simple. So, vous pourrez, remember to write it, P-O-U-R-R-E-Z. Vous pourrez, so this is the future form of pouvoir. Pouvoir to be able, can. Then, after that, we've got two substantives. So, the first one is grillade. Grillade, so remember that it's feminine. In that case, you don't see that because it's the plural form. So, une grillade. Grillade, you will write it G-R-I-L-L-A-D-E, singular form, and now with the S. Grillade. Victoria Jacques saying, well, everything is true. It's a delicious wine. Tout est vrai. Ce vin est délicieux, nous dit Victoria Jacques. And the last thing, it was de la volaille. Volaille, as you can see, is feminine. And you write it V-O-L-A-I-L-L-E. Allez. Nous allons finir, so let's finish with this wine. So as usual, remember, I'm expecting you to pronounce with me out loud because this is the best way to make some progress for the pronunciation and also to remember the words. Numéro 1. Vous retrouverez des arômes de fruits rouges comme la fraise, la cerise, la framboise, mais aussi une note de vanille. Deuxième chose. Ce vin rouge a une robe rouge rubis. Ses tanins sont fins et fondus, ce qui en fait un vrai vin de plaisir. Troisième chose, vous pourrez déguster le sixième sens avec des grillades, de la volaille ou du fromage. Alors, we've been starting this series, well, not so long ago. It was finish the sentence, or this series of exercises. Finish the sentence, well, it's a simple thing. In fact, I give you the first part and then you just imagine the rest. But then keep in mind that in that case, je vous invite à, well, let's see how you will structure the rest. Whether you will put a verb, whether you will put, let's see exactly. And of course, I will be there to correct your sentences. So go for it. Je vous invite à, just imagine the rest of the sentence. It is a sentence. On y va. Alors, De Victor Ent is joining us. Bonjour, bonjour, you can participate. This exercise is quite simple. You just need to finish the sentence and you just put that in the chat. Daria is the first one to write, je vous invite à mettre un like. C'est vrai, only five. Oh, come on. Only five likes. Please be nice. I will press on my little magic button here. Look, five likes. Be nice with me. It's my little pleasure. Come on. Allez, ce serait gentil. Bien sûr, bien sûr. Donc, merci Daria. Thank you very much for reminding us that people should click definitely. Let's look at the other sentences. So, voilà, Omar. Omar, je vous invite à jouer au tennis. Très bien. Désiré, je vous invite à participer à la séance d'aujourd'hui. Très bien. Je vous invite à visiter mon pays, nous dit Eka. Remember, Eka, pays, you write it P-A-Y-S. Ashwati, je vous invite à ma maison pour mon anniversaire. Ouais. Ashwati, in most of the cases, well, à participer à mon anniversaire, because you would go for chez moi, so it would not be possible with the A. Je vous invite chez moi pour mon anniversaire, je vous invite à participer à mon anniversaire. Ritu, je vous invite chez moi pour une tasse de thé et on va s'amuser. Desarlika, je vous invite à jouer avec moi. Yossi, je vous invite à faire un voyage, attention Yossi c'est masculin, voyage autour du monde avec moi. Dolma qui nous dit je vous invite à la plage. Fiona, je vous invite à dîner. Yasmine, je vous invite à une wine party. Ah ben ça il faut inviter Victoria Jacques et uniquement le sixième sens avec elle. Rupa, je vous invite à faire la fête chez moi. Ouais, you don't need to put un, d'accord? A, and then you put straight your verb, faire la fête. Tiffany, je vous invite à ma fête d'anniversaire dans un lieu secret. Lovina, je vous invite au jardin. So remember, Lovina, when you combine A and L, you will get this O form. Remember, A-U. Au jardin japonais. Hilary, je vous invite à prendre soin de vous. Très bien. Alors, attendez, je vous ai perdu. Maria Bethania, je vous invite à déjeuner. Remember, it goes with a after your J. Emma Chomaoma, alors attendez, je vous invite à donner des pouces bleus pour cette vidéo. Oh, c'est gentil. Souvenez-vous, vidéo, c'est féminin. So, because it's feminine, you would go for set. Remember the demonstrative. C-E-T-T-E. Cosmina Bellou, je vous invite à voir mon deuxième œil. Qu'est-ce que ça veut dire? Ah, c'est des messages secrets, je ne comprends pas. Marcel Pereira, je vous invite à apprendre avec moi. Be careful, avec Marcel, you will write it A-V-E-C. Mouskan, je vous invite à mon anniversaire en Inde, dans un grand restaurant avec beaucoup de cuisine indienne qui sont très délicieuses. Maybe instead of cuisine, plat. As we saw, this dish concept would be plat. Beaucoup de plats, and it's masculine, so indien, I-N-D-I-E-N-S. Léoul Kiros, je vous invite à boire du café. Bourneville Lover, je vous invite à finir mon travail. Yep, be careful, Bourneville Lover. Travail, it's when it's the noun, the substantive, you write it T-R-A-V-A-I-L. Nothing else. Curiosidades, je vous invite à un verre de vin pendant qu'on regarde les étoiles la nuit. Ada, puisque vous êtes confiné chez vous, je vous invite à regarder un film de Jean-Luc Godard. Ah, you know what, Ada, one of my favorite movies is, I mean, it used to be, now it's been changing, but it used to be for a long time, Le Mépris. And in Le Mépris from Jean-Luc Godard, you've got this music, this incredible music from Georges Delerue. And it's a great, great movie. Mostly for the music, in fact. I mean, the rest. Well, Michel Piccoli is good in there. Dipti, je vous invite à Bordeaux pour mon anniversaire. Ice Cubes, je vous invite à Paris après la pandémie pour essayer tous les vins et les fromages. In that case, yeah. It would be difficult to walk after. Bickert, je vous invite à jouer des cartes chez nous pour le soir. Victoria Jacques, je vous invite à profiter au mieux de votre journée. Olga Ruiz, je vous invite à la plage. Ritu, d'accord. Victoria Jacques, ok. You start to discuss with each other, so I'm not... Je vous invite, alors, Yeon Yang, je vous invite à aller faire les courses avec moi ce soir, d'accord? D'accord? Après, c'est des réponses. Merci beaucoup! Alors, as you probably know, I would not be professional and I would have some difficulties to look at myself in the mirror if we would not do the verb of the day. Remember, the verb of the day is the possibility for us to work on the conjugation. And in that case, I wanted to pick, in fact, an interesting verb. So it's interesting because, in fact, it belongs to the first group. So it's payer. Hein? Payer, remember, P-A-Y-E-R. This is the way to write it properly. But it's a bit tricky and we will see why. So in that case, because these are all the tenses that normally you should master. So we've got the three moods, indicative, conditionnel and subjonctif. But in fact, look at the tenses that normally at this level, so between intermediate and advanced, you should master. So you should be able to conjugate verbs at the following tenses. Okay, we will scan all these tenses. And in fact, I will only focus, or we will only focus, on the je form. So let's start with the present. Present of payer, indicatif présent. Allez-y. Alors, I can see that your answers are arriving. And clearly, I can see that there are two versions. And let me reassure you, in fact, payer is among these verbs that has two possibilities, in fact, well, for the present. And we will see that there are two other tenses that are exactly in the same situation. So it means that you can write it whether P-A-I-E, je paie, or then P-A-Y-E, je paie, or then je paye. So it depends. In some cases, you can hear people saying je paye, and then some persons will go for je paie. In my case, for instance, but I'm not young anymore, so I was taught that it was the first version. The first version was the original one, P P-A-I-E, but now we tend to accept the second one too. So it's up to you. You can write it whether with E or Y. Let's have a look at now the futur proche. Remember, futur proche, it's the verb aller in the present form with the infinitive. So what is the futur proche of payer? Alors, we agree that it's the verb aller that we conjugate in the first form, je vais, and then we put payer, just like that. So, je vais payer. Near future, we agree that it is something that will happen for sure, and it's not in 1 year. So, it's something that should be in the near future, by definition. Futur simple, so the real future, could you please give me payer in a futur simple form. Alors, I can see that it's starting to arrive. So, same thing here. Remember, I told you, payer, it's the first group, but still it's a bit tricky because in that case, futur simple, and obviously we can anticipate that it will be the same thing for the conditionnel présent. You can see that we have these two possibilities to write it. So, the first option, like we had previously, with E, and the second option, with Y. So first one, remember how to pronounce it, it will be je paierai. So in fact, this E in the middle is totally mute, je paierai, je paierai. And then the second option, it's je paierai too. You can hear some persons using this paierai, which is not really beautiful, but it's just to my point of view. And that's just the way I was taught. So je paierai, or then je paierai, but it's really not beautiful. Go for paierai, please. So remember, the way to properly write it, whether with E or then with Y, and that's it for the futur simple. Allez, on continue avec, let's continue with passé récent. Remember, passé récent, it was venir, so in the present. Don't forget the preposition de, and then after that, l'infinitif. Give me the first person, please. Alors, we agree that the verb venir, when you conjugate it in the present, so it's je viens, V-E-N-S. Then you don't forget the preposition de, it's really important. And after that, you just put your verb payer like that in the infinitive, je viens de payer. Remember that this structure, it's the just concept in English. I just paid, je viens de payer. Once again, because of the structure, it means that it's something that really happened I mean, quite recently, so it's not something that happened 1 month ago or 1 year ago. It's totally, it's not possible. So let's continue with the real compound tense here. And it's the first one, passé composé. Alors, I can see that your answers are arriving, so it's really good. So it's the first compound tense of the list, in fact. So what does it mean? It means that we will need to use a helping verb. Helping verbs, we've got only two. We've got avoir or être. In most of the cases, if you have a doubt, go for avoir. And this is the case with payer, for instance. So we use avoir. Avoir will be conjugated in the present. J'ai. And then in the second place, you will put your past participle. Le participe passé of this verb payer. And in that case, it's simple. It's payer with the accent. So j'ai payer will be the passé composé form of your beautiful verb payer. Give me please now l'imparfait. So same thing here, imparfait, première personne, the first person. Alors, félicitations. I think it's Yossi. Yossi is always good with the conjugation. Well, he's good with a lot of things, Yossi. We need to admit that. He's extremely gifted with the languages. So, here it's je payais. So the root will be paye, P-A-Y. And after that, you will just add your endings, A-I-S. Je payais, tu payais, il, elle payait. Remember, A-I-S, A-I-S, and then A-I-T. So I think I'm looking at what you're writing. So far, so good. Huh? So maybe, Azad, it seems that you're a bit you're not really synchronized. Sila is joining us. Hi, Sila, you can do some conjugation with us. It's not really ole ole, but I mean, we need to do it. Let's continue with the second compound tenses, and it's plus que parfait. Give me, please, the first person of plus que parfait. Alors, we do agree that it's the second compound tense. What does it mean? It means that it's exactly the same concept. So it means that we need to use the same helping verb, that is avoir. Avoir should be conjugated in the imparfait form. So this is the reason why. Sorry, I didn't press on the button. You can see on your screen, j'avais. So it's conjugated in the imparfait in that case. Second thing will be payer. So the past participle will be payé, remember, with the accent. So, j'avais payé is your plus que parfait form. Allez, on continue, si vous voulez bien, with the next one. The next one is the third compound tense, and it's futur antérieur. Futur antérieur, could you please give me the first person? Alors, c'est clair, and it's really good in fact, so let's agree on that. I told you, third compound tense, so it means that, of course, now we know that we will use avoir. Avoir in that situation should be in the future simple form. J'aurai, look at your screen, and then after that, as usual, we will put the past participle. Past participle of payer is, one more time, payer with the beautiful accent aigu in the end. So let's have a look now at, we're going for conditionnel présent. Be careful. I told you, payer, tricky verb, for présent, futur simple, and conditionnel présent. So remember and try to, if there are several forms, try to give them. Thank you. Alors, I must say bravo to Yossi first, because Yossi nicely gave me the two forms, so the one with the E and the one with the Y. I can see that Hilary Hallwell too, she did that, and it's really good. Ice cubes too, so yeah, Yasmin also. So this is the concept, and keep that in mind, is that for these three tenses, in fact, the present, the futur simple, and the conditionnel présent, well, we'll have this tricky thing, so whether you go for the E, like I personally do, but that's the way I was taught. Or then you go for the Y. It's changing slightly the pronunciation. I don't personally like it, but after that, it's just a question of taste. Huh? So whether you go for the E, in that case, remember, E will be not pronounced. So, je paierai. Je paierai. Or then you keep your Y and then you can hear je paierai. Je paierai. Which, well, it's a question of taste. It's a question of taste. Personally, I would advise you to go for the first one. I think it sounds nicer, quand même, non? And let's finish with conditionnel passé. Alors, conditionnel passé, compound tense, one more time. So could you give me, please, the je form? Alors, Sapna is a bit late, but it's okay. Don't worry, Sapna. Just join. Well, we're finishing the conjugation. After that, you can do the exercises with us. Okay, so one more time, we agree. So now it's the last compound tense that we have, at least for this exercise, for the intermediate. So it means that j'aurais, in that case, yes. So we use avoir. Avoir should be, one more time, in the conditionnel présent form. J'aurais. And then we use right after, well, the participe passé, the past participle, and it's still the same, it's payé with the accent in the end. J'aurai payé will be your conditionnel passé form. Félicitations, merci beaucoup, merci, merci, c'était formidable. « So even if we've been reaching this 100, and I'm so happy. I am so happy. It's just like that. It's just a relief. It's a relief. So, but still, it's possible to like it more because, I mean, of course, there is a slight difference between the number of persons who are watching the thing and then the likes. But click one more time. It would please me so much. And that's it. So we can continue. Don't forget to share. Invite your family and your friends or maybe your colleague even. Alors, in that situation, I would like you to finish the question. So you can see that it's the same concept as we had with the sentence, but in that case, it should be a question. And the question is, est-ce que tu penses que? Est-ce que tu penses que? Try to finish the question and let's see what you will write. Allez, you've got 1 minute to do it. I think it would be, it's good, no? Alors, Deepti is tired, she needs to go, elle est fatiguée, mais c'est pas grave, Deepti. Allez vous reposer et nous nous voyons bientôt, à demain. Alors, Prachi is the first one to say, est-ce que tu penses que c'est vrai? Très bien écrit, Prachi, really good. Yossi, est-ce que tu penses qu'il pleuvra? When you look at the boy and the dog. Ensuite, Désiré, est-ce que tu penses que Marie viendra ce soir? Desarlika, est-ce que tu penses qu'il est son ami? Hop, you've been removing. Be careful. Oui, it should have been with the S, tu penses. Ashwati, est-ce que tu penses que le chien peut parler? It's a good question, in fact, Ashwati. It is a really good question. Marlène, est-ce que tu penses que le confinement va finir un jour? It must, because it won't end in a nice way if it doesn't. Véro Paul, est-ce que tu penses qu'il va pleuvoir? Be careful, you should put the infinitive of pleuvoir. Dolma, est-ce que tu penses qu'il y a de la vraie amitié? Eh oui, il faut espérer. Eka, est-ce que tu penses que maman va venir souvent? Omar, est-ce que tu penses... Attention, it goes too fast. Est-ce que tu penses que je ne pourrais pas... pas aller chez toi. Don't forget, yeah, Omar, don't forget when you drop the negative, one negative part, in that case, it should be the first one. So, ne can be dropped, pas, absolutely not, okay? So, est-ce que tu penses que je ne pourrais pas aller chez toi? Ada, est-ce que tu penses que Paris est la plus belle ville du monde? Mouskan, est-ce que tu penses qu'elle va venir? Remember, Mouskan, quel Q-U apostrophe. Tiffany, est-ce que tu penses que le corona va durer 3 ans? Non! Don't even mention that, Tiffany. You will bring bad luck to us. Ah non, pas 3 ans. Ah non. I don't want that. Hein. Ah non, c'est long, 3 ans. Hein. Rupa, est-ce que tu penses que le Covid-19 se terminera cette année? Oui. Cosmina Bellou, est-ce que tu penses que je puisse avoir un meilleur ami que toi? Ça, c'est une bonne question. Hein. Un chien, c'est toujours très fidèle. Lovina, est-ce que tu penses qu'il va pleuvoir? Yesero, est-ce que tu penses que papa apportera un McDo? Ice Cubes, est-ce que tu penses que ce cours est très amusant pour apprendre le français? Oh, j'espère. Curiosidades, est-ce que tu penses que les rêves sont une forme de communication entre votre subconscient et votre esprit conscient? Ben oui. pourrait discuter longtemps, mais oui. Yasmine, est-ce que tu penses que 2021 sera une bonne année? Oui. Desarlika, est-ce que tu penses que nous avons suffisamment, remember you should go for the adverb, hein, suffisamment de likes? C'est discutable. Fiona Adams, est-ce que tu penses, pensez-vous que le confinement sera bientôt terminé? Maria Betania, est-ce que tu penses que je vais sortir aujourd'hui? Véropol, est-ce que tu penses, remember to put S at the end of pense, qu'on peut manger ensemble? Léol Kiros, est-ce que tu penses que la lune bleue est bonne? Oh bah, toutes les lunes sont bonnes. Sapna, est-ce que vous pensez que pourquoi les gens ne vont pas liker comme aujourd'hui? Oh, j'ai toujours peur. Curiosidades, est-ce que tu penses que je gagnerai un jour un prix dans les vidéos de Vincent? I'm doing my best. I would like that everyone could win. I mean, of course, but... Hein? Hilary, est-ce que tu penses que le facteur viendra? Ça, c'est une bonne question. Alors, remember that for the beginners and the intermediate, in most of the cases, I like to have these exercises with the translation. So in that case, it will be mostly, it will be only, by the way, only nouns, and it will be the rooms of the house. Okay, so this is the theme, this is the concept. So we'll have 10, I guess, rooms. And so we start with the first one and look at that. How would you translate the kitchen in French? Remember to put the article just to see if it's masculine or feminine. Allez-y. Alors, we agree that it's la cuisine. Remember to write it properly. C-U-I-S-I-N-E. La cuisine. So let's have a look at the second one. The second one is the bathroom. So how would you translate the bathroom into French? Remember that the bathroom in French is in fact la salle de bain. Hein? So la salle de bain, so la, and then after that salle, S-A-L-L-E, then de, and bain would be B-A-I-N. Olga Ruiz, it seems that you're a bit, you're not really synchronized with us. Maybe you want to refresh. Refresh your page and then you will be synchronized. So let's have a look at the number three. Number three is the bedroom. How would you translate the bedroom into French? Alors, the bedroom is, in fact, you've got two options. Whether you go for la chambre, which is in most of the cases what we will use, but then you can say la chambre à coucher. La chambre à coucher is the official way to call this bedroom, but in fact, in most of the cases, we're talking about la chambre. And if you use this chambre concept or word, if you talk about, a room, your room, don't say la chambre, because I've got the feeling that there is a bed. There is a bed in the room, so if you say la chambre, then for us, it's always connected to sleeping or there is a bed. So be careful with that. Numéro 4, the dining room. Alors, effectivement, the dining room, let me click on Bickert. I don't know why you were blocked, it's strange. The dining room is la salle à manger. So in that case, you can see that we will put the verb manger, so the infinitive form, M-A-N-G-E-R. La salle à manger is the dining room. Let's have a look at number 5, and it's the living room. How would you translate the living room into French? Alors, in that case, we agree that we will have, two main options nowadays. First option would be le salon, so remember that it's masculine, un salon, le salon, or then we can say le living. Persons who say la salle de séjour, yeah, it's an option, la salle de séjour, but it's not really used a lot nowadays, but it's an option. So you could say la salle de séjour, le salon, le living. In most of the cases, people will go for the short version, so le salon or le living. Let's look at number 6, well, the toilets or the restroom. How would you translate that into French? How is it possible? Because I'm looking at the stats at the same time. I can see 145 persons and only, 103 likes. It's not reasonable. Click on the like if you didn't do it so far, because I am looking at you. I can see that you didn't click on the like. Alors, we agree that in that case, it must be in the plural form, because toilette, when you're talking about this room of the house or room of your apartment, it is always the plural form, les toilettes. Remember that when it's the feminine form, singular, it's la toilette. But in that case, you're talking about, well, the dress or the way a woman will be dressed. So une toilette, it's totally different. So remember to put that always in the plural form. So it means that, of course, the verb will be conjugated according to that. Où sont les toilettes? And you go for être in the plural form. Où sont les toilettes? Désiré, on peut dire aussi les WC. Oui, oui, oui. Vous pouvez dire les WC si vous voulez, les toilettes. Well, it depends. Go for toilette. Same thing. I mean, it's possible to use désiré, but then personally, I would go for toilette. Où sont les toilettes? I think it's nicer than où sont les WC, but it's personal, once again. So go for numéro 7, the office. If you've got an office in your place, then how would you call that in French? Alors, Yossi is trying to explain the fact that people are coming and going. Well, the thing is that, Yossi, you know, people come and go when you've got a stream like that. So I've got the stats always, you know, in real time. And in fact, the funny thing is that in most of the... Well, what you see is the number of viewers. So at right now, you've got 130-something. But in fact, since the beginning of the stream, we had 6,635 people who came and left or stayed, or so it's like so I should deserve at least 150 likes. So let's look at the next one. Le bureau is bien sûr the word that we use. So le bureau is masculine, and remember to write it with A-U in the end. So let's look at numéro 8. Numéro 8, it's the entrance. So it could be discussed. Is it a room or not? Well, at least it's a part of the house. So could you please tell me what it is in French? Alors, somebody is asking me to say his or her name. But the first thing, I mean, the first rule is that, I mean, there is the magic word. And the magic word is please. In French, it's s'il vous plaît or s'il te plaît. Without that, nothing is possible. So in that case, it's entrée. Entrée would be really the translation of the entrance. And in that case, it's feminine. So I've been putting the F just for you to know that it's une entrée. Somebody was putting, Ada was putting le couloir. Le couloir, it's more like the corridor, so it's not really connected with the fact that you are coming in the house. So this entrée is really the same concept, d'accord? So that's the way it goes. And don't ask me to say your name, because, you know, without the magic word... You won't have it. Numéro 9. On continue. The dressing room. How could you translate that into French? Alors, it seems that it's a bit more difficult in that case. So, you know, when it's difficult, let's make it simple. So, in most of the cases, nowadays, people, we use the le dressing. Somebody was putting la garde-robe. Non, not really, not really. Yesero cabine d'essayage. No, it's only in a shop or in a boutique in that case, okay? When we're talking about the house, in that case, just go simple. People will use the English word dressing. They pronounce it le dressing, like usually for French people. Numéro 10. Numéro 10, it's the last one, so try to put the guest room. So how would you translate the guest room in French? Alors, it's interesting because in that case, as you can see, in French, so we will use la chambre d'amis. And so it means that this concept is more related to friends than to guests. We don't really use this guest concept. In fact, in French, we will use this ami, la chambre d'amis, so it will be the guest room. So the room, if you have one, where the, well, I mean the persons who come to visit you will have the chance to sleep. So la chambre d'amis, in French, it will be connected to friendships or friends more than guests. And that concludes this interesting exercise. Ali, in that case, I would like you to start the sentence. And then the end of the thing is, et moi aussi. So try to imagine how the sentence is starting. Alors, je crois que c'est... Est-ce que c'est Bickert qui est là en premier qui nous dit... Qui nous dit... Je suis d'accord, et moi aussi. Yeah, well, it's a bit strange to to. Then il est d'accord et moi aussi. Je n'aime pas mon travail et moi aussi. Be careful, you see, because it's et moi aussi. It's not et moi non plus. Hein? So you need to be really, really careful. Je suis désolé et moi aussi. It should not be the first. I mean, the same subject. So a cas, it's a bit difficult too. Alors, Gilgamesh, tu es bon aux échecs et moi aussi. This is perfect because you don't have the same subject and it's good. Dolma, tu profites bien dans la nature, moi aussi. Yasmine, tu aimes le chocolat et moi aussi. tout le monde est le, aime le chocolat. Ensuite, je regarde... qu'est-ce qu'il y a d'autre? Je suis heureux pour vous et moi aussi. Yossi qui nous dit... Alors, attendez. Yossi nous dit... Ah non, c'était la même chose. Travail. D'accord? Ensuite, regardons. Yessero, je vois. Yessero, Yossi aime les passés simples et moi aussi. D'accord. Hilary, tu es heureuse et moi aussi. Maria Bethania, vous aimez les jeux de société et moi aussi. Prachi, d'ouvrage. Ah non, c'est autre chose ça. Omar, elle est très concentrée et moi aussi. Desarlika, vous aimez apprendre et moi aussi. Léol Kiros nous dit, alors attendez, à vous de même et moi aussi. Curiosidades, les gens ont tendance à penser au sens de la vie, moi aussi. Le sens de la vie est basé sur notre but, nos objectifs, nos réalisations. Waouh. Alors Victoria Jacques, c'est plus léger. Tu aimes l'apéritif et moi aussi. Fiona Adams, elle est belle et moi aussi. Sapna, vous profitez beaucoup de cette chaîne et moi aussi. Olga Ruiz, elle pense moi aussi. C'est un petit peu bizarre, Olga Ruiz. Merci beaucoup, Tiffany, pour le cadeau. Véropole, tu es brillant et moi aussi. Ensuite, ah ben c'est tout. Allez, on va faire le dernier exercice pour aujourd'hui. Alors, vous le savez, you know it, the idea is to try to make dictations almost daily, so this is normally what we try to do. I guess that yesterday it was not possible because it was a bit too long, like today, we need to make it shorter, I guess. So this is the dictation of the day, it's extremely simple, we'll have four sentences, I will read them, you will have to write them. You need to be careful because I will write the translation, so whether you look at the translation but it's maybe not really helping you, or then you don't look at the translation, and in that case you just concentrate on what I say and you try to write the sentences. I give you the two options just to make it nicer. Even if you have some difficulties, then maybe it can help you. Okay, so we'll start right now with the first one, and the first one is, one second, because I need to look at it. On y va. J'adore manger des frites. J'adore manger des frites. Thank you. Okay, one second, because of course I've been making a little mistake. I had to remove some slides, of course, because we cannot do everything as planned. So of course it's not possible. So one second, please. Et nous voilà de retour. Merci pour votre patience. Thank you very much. So we're back. So it was j'adore manger des frites. Regardez ici. So clearly I wanted to use well regular verb j'adore. So it's not really difficult. You put that in the first person. So it should end with a. Second verb should be definitely in the infinitive form. Then after that you've got des. Alors des, Yossi is asking, is it de plus les? Technically yes, it is de plus les, but it's also what we call, I mean, this I missed the name now. it's not going in my mind, it's not working. I've got the technical thing, but yes, to answer shortly to you, Yossi, de plus les is des. So it should be in the plural form, so frites should be with S in the end. Allez, let's continue and let's hope it will not break before the end of the live. Today was a bit challenging. Elle ne supporte pas mon accent. Elle ne supporte pas mon accent. Yes, it's partitif, Mouskan. Thank you very much. Alors, as you can see, the verb is supporté, regular verb from the first group, so it means that you need to conjugate it in the third person of the singular, supporte, S-U-P-P-O-R-T-E. So this is simple, then you put the negative form before and after the verb, elle ne supporte pas, and you finish with accent. Accent, it's a masculine word, it's un accent, so you write it A-C-C-E-N-T, and obviously for the possessive adjective you need to put the masculine form mon. Elle ne supporte pas mon accent. Voilà, voilà. Let's look at the next one, numéro 3. So remember, same thing here, I put the translation, but it's up to you to look at it or not, and then well, we can have the sentence now. Nous pouvons aller voir ce film. Nous pouvons aller voir ce film. Write the sentence. Thank you. Alors, regardons la phrase. Let's have a look at the sentence. And yeah, Ice Cube says, wow, three verbs together. Yep, it was just to show you. So as you can see, I mean, it's possible to have at least one, two, even three verbs together. But it means that, I mean, as you can see, the rule is quite similar. So it means that the first one is conjugated. In that case, it's the verb pouvoir. Nous pouvons. D'accord? Then the second verb is in the infinitive form aller. Nous pouvons aller. And finally, voir is also in the infinitive form voir. Nous pouvons aller voir. And then we finish with film. Once again, masculine word. So it means that ce will be the masculine form, the demonstrative. So, c'est nous pouvons aller voir ce film. Let's have a look at the last one. Same thing here. Remember, if you don't want to look at the translation, don't look at it, but it will be there. So, you need to be aware. So, let's see the last one. Tu veux vraiment lui parler? Tu veux vraiment lui parler? Alors, as you can see, well, in that case, I am starting with the verb vouloir, and vouloir in that situation, as you can see, is conjugated in the present form, second person, so it should be written V-E-U-X, tu veux. Then I'm putting an adverb, vraiment. And so the last, I mean, the second verb is parler, which should be definitely in the infinitive form. Parler, P-A-R-L-E-R. But then remember that the pronoun should be before the verb it is related to. So in that case, lui is connected to parler, so it should be before this verb. And it's interesting because in fact, for us, this pronoun is pronom complément d'objet indirect, and it means that whether it's for the masculine or the feminine, it will be lui. It will be only the same, I mean, it will be the same form for the good reason that it was previously mentioned. So as it was previously mentioned, we know exactly if it's a man or a woman. So in that case, it's not really a problem. But in English, of course, as you can see, you need to make the difference between the feminine and the masculine. So in French, tu veux vraiment lui parler. And that concludes the dictations. Merci beaucoup. Alors, maintenant, so this is the end, and when it's the end, well, it means that basically you've got the chance to win. Youpi, remember the way it will go, we will respect the same thing Of course, you don't start right now. Please, you wait for the music, because otherwise I won't take your number. And so it would be a bit sad, like we had in the previous game, the person won, but unfortunately it was before the music. So wait for the music. Then only the persons who didn't win yet can participate. I mean, the persons who have been winning before, in that case, they cannot participate. I think it's just fair. The concept is quite simple. In fact, I will write, and I just did it now. I will write, I wrote a number on my paper, and it's right there. It's from 1 to 100, you know that. Then you will have to guess it. Remember, only one number per person. Same thing. If you don't respect the rules, then I won't take your number. This is just, you know, the fact. And after that, well, the person who win in that case will get an access to French with Vincent. Some persons apparently didn't manage to reach the site. It's up and running. It's been there for a while now, so it should be accessible. Remember to put the www if needed, or HTTPS, I don't really know what browser you're using. But anyways, this is the way it will go. We have Ice Cubes, who is now looking at the fact that everybody is respecting the rule, and if there is a problem, then... Eh oui. This is the way it will go. Remember, this is the way it will go, and you won't be able to win, and it would be really, really sad. So, if everything is clear now, well, good luck! Good luck, and one person will win, I hope. On y va. You can start now. Alors, it went really, really fast. So the question now is... Attendez une petite seconde. Voilà. Véro Paul, are you here? Véro Paul, are you here? Because Véro Paul, if you are here, then you are the lucky winner. Bravo, 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 bravo. You've been winning because you've been finding the number. And it was 37. Bravo, Véro Paul. Alors, Véro Paul, you are here and it's good. So let's agree on that. Look, you just need to register to FrenchWithVincent.com. So remember to put the www or then the HTTPS, but then the address is working. And after that, you send me, a message, an email at the winner at fluent2plus.com, and I will give you the access to the platform. You will have a lot of lessons and and then it will be really good if you want to learn French. You will have a lot of videos to work on. So, merci beaucoup. Thank you very much. I hope you enjoyed the lesson. At least I did it. Thank you very much. See you tomorrow. It will be the advanced lesson, so it will be only in French. Or then after that, the same thing, beginner, intermediate, and advanced. Merci beaucoup. Au revoir et à bientôt.